Well, guys, I finally did it. I got me a van. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, man, he's just following the same suit as everyone else, going out, buying a van, just so you can get some views, just so you can be like Single Track Sampler and every other YouTuber that's making millions and millions of views. But no, really, this is really a huge convenience. Like, you know, before I had a van, I didn't know what was missing from my life, but when I got a van, it changed something in me. It's all about freedom, baby. So today, I'm gonna give you guys a van tour of my new van. All right, so first thing I need to do is show you guys how much space I got in this thing. It's freaking gnarly. So check this out. I got two seats, a steering wheel, a place to put my coffee. Oh, and when I get really tired, and put my feet up like this. Like, I just can't believe how much room I got. I mean, this is a game changer. Everyone knows the first thing you need to do when you get a van is to find a place to put your ibuprofen. Because if you don't have ibuprofen, like, you're gonna get the migraines and it's just gonna mess up that whole freedom thing we were just talking about. So what I do is I open this little cubby slot and I put them in there. Boom, it's so organized, it's beautiful. All right, guys, so you all know how much I love camera gear. My camera gear is like my children. Like, I love it, I need it, gotta have it. If I can't have my camera gear and it's not organized, I get really upset. So first thing I did was I bought this van because it comes equipped with two seat belts to put my camera gear in. The strap just fits over just like that. You just take this, put it over your, clicked up, fastened up, boom. I could fit two different backpacks in here. One for mountain biking and one my camera stuff. Guys, I even got a changing room in this thing. Let me show you. I'm gonna pull out my changing room. Take out my changing room. Look at that. Full on changing room. This thing is dope. Take my pants off, take anything off, underwear, whatever, no one can tell. Can't get arrested, nothing. This is, I don't even know. I don't even have words. Don't even have words. All right, so next I wanted to show you guys my bike rack. When I put my bike, this is where all the magic happens. This is a 1UP USA bike rack. It's called a quick rack because it's super quick. No hands required. Come over here. I got some extra windshield wiper stuff. You know, you're ever caught in the middle of absolutely nowhere and like you're stranded, you don't got no food, you don't got nothing, none of the essentials, no self-protection, no nothing. At least you got some windshield fluid. That'll get you by for some time. And the other thing I got is one can of oil, because you never know when just oil is gonna spill out everywhere. All right, so I got me a Cannondale pump that matches perfectly with my Yeti SB150. Like, that's just like the best combination right there. It's got a wood finish. Like, that's, like, it doesn't even matter that this thing isn't even accurate. Let's pull out the bare essentials. I got me my soap to wash my bike. I got me some protectant stuff to protect my Invisiframe. What else I got? So check it out, I got channel locks. You can pretty much use this for anything on a mountain bike. Like, you'd be surprised what you could do with just one pair of channel locks. Like you know, you see Park Tool charge all this money for like all these, you get $300, you get all these tools, like all these meaningless tools. Just get yourself a pair of channel locks, guys. You'd be really surprised about what you could do with them. Check this out, this is cool. This is actually legit. This kryptonite, I got some kryptonite. So if I ever need to go inside and lock my bike up real quick on my rack, this gives me some extra protection. So if like someone tries to steal it, it'd be just a little bit more harder for them to steal it, because this thing, kryptonite. Always, don't ever forget your toothpaste. But this thing is really freaking cool. So one of the things I keep in here is this little lamp. It has like one of those little like UV things where it recharges it on its own and you turn it on and it like lasts forever. It's like self-charging. This thing is freaking cool. got my hatchet if I ever have to, you know, defend myself against a coyote. And then you got this Freeland blow-up bed, which is kind of cool. So when I need to sleep in the car, I'll use this and I'll put the seats down and I'll blow this up. Now, I usually keep my tent back here, and when I use my tent, I have a blow-up bed that fits right here. And I always keep a extra pair of underwear and a t-shirt here just in case. You know, it's kind of funny though. For some reason, the only pair I have in here is one with a hole in it. I don't know, maybe I should get a new one. Might be kind of useful. All right guys, so here's a little hack. So if you ever got to go in to eat or something like that, you want to go sit down and you just feel a lot safer putting your bike inside of your van, you know, which most people do anyway. What you can do so people don't look in the window, I sometimes will put this over my bike to hide it. So like someone looks in the car, all they'll see is... So if you guys are unfamiliar with my pride of joy, so I got a Yeti SB150. If I had to pick five things that I love most about this bike is, number one, and what matters most, is that it looks freaking cool. I mean, that's the most important thing about a bike, is if it don't look cool, like why ride it? Like it just doesn't make no sense. Like if I'm in my house and I'm sitting there and I'm like feeling all lazy and stuff, and I'm just like, you know what? I feel like I need to get out and ride. I'm getting fat, I'm getting all unhealthy, my family's falling apart and everything. I really should exercise. None of that matters. All that matters is that your bike looks cool, because that is really the only thing that's gonna get you out on a ride. So guys, spend a lot of money on a bike, because the more money you spend, the more you're gonna ride it. So that's number one. Second coolest thing about this bike is that it's Kashima. I love Kashima. Guys, I can't tell any difference between Kashima or RockShox. It makes no difference to me. If I was blind riding my mountain bike, I could never tell. It makes no difference. I've ridden all kinds of forks. I can't tell a difference. So who cares? But still, everyone should have Kashima, because it's gold. It looks amazing. Because this is the thing. If you have Kashima, like as you like go by people like look at your bike and they go, wow, that bike costs $5,000 more than my bike costs. And they just look at you like, whoa, like that's what Kashima does. That's the effect, the psychological effect that Kashima has on everyone who sees it. I just can't think of five right now, but I think what really matters is that this bike is a Yeti. And when you buy a Yeti, you get a tribe. Like, how many people can say that? Like, you buy a bike and now you got a tribe. I never met none of them, I never seen any of them, but I know they're out there. You know, perhaps probably the most amazing thing about having a van, it's not the fact that I don't have to work anymore, or the fact that I don't have to like stay planted at one place, one time, same day, same boss, you know, getting paid pennies on the dollar. Like none of that matters. I think the coolest thing about having a van, having a YouTube channel, is that I get to basically have a better life than anybody else watching this YouTube video. But what really matters is you guys. At the end of the day, this is all for you, not me. I die for all of you.